Using the principal axis theorem, we can always get rid of the mixed terms in our quadratic forms. So for sketching of level sets, we only need to look at quadratic forms without these mixed terms. And in this video, we will turn our attention to sketching of level sets. We will restrict ourselves to quadratic forms in two variables, so we can sketch in 2D. Otherwise, we would need to make 3D pictures, which can be quite difficult to draw. And furthermore, we will see what happens if we also include some linear terms in our quadratic forms, so they are not linear, so they are not quadratic forms anymore. And as it turns out, this is no problem at all as well, because we can easily get rid of these linear terms. So let's take a look at a few examples. So function of two variables and no mixed terms. So we set, for example, x1 squared over a squared plus x2 squared over b squared. In other words, we put two positive constants. So what do we get as our level sets? Well, hopefully you will recognize this. These will become ellipses, increasing in size if you make the constant bigger. For example, if you draw the level set where f equals 1, you get an ellipse which intersects the x1 axis at a, because then x2 equals 0. So if f equals 1, this term equals 0, you get x1 equals a. And here, in this point of intersection, you have x1 equals 0. So if you intersect, you get x2 equals b. So there you have your ellipse. It's basically a circle which is a bit squeezed in this direction or in that one. So that's one example of a quadratic form. Now, what happens if we have some linear terms? So we don't have a quadratic form anymore, but we still can try to sketch the level sets of this function f. So what happens then? Unfortunately, we can also get rid of the linear terms by the following trick. We can complete the squares. So you take the x1 squared minus 4x1 together, complete the square, so you get an x1 minus 2 squared. Well, that would give you an x1 squared minus 4x1, which is good, plus 4. So you have to subtract the 4. And then we want to absorb the 6x2 in the x2 squared. So we pull out the 3 first, so we get 3 times x2 squared plus 1. And then we complete the square, so x2 squared plus 1 yields x2 plus 1 squared. Well, that would yield the x2 squared plus 2x2 plus 1, so you have to subtract a minus 1. So what do we get then if we combine everything? The x1 minus 2 squared over here, 3 times x2 plus 1 squared, and a minus 4, a minus 3, together a minus 7. So there we go. So what do we have over here? Well, if we sketch, for example, the level curves f equals minus 3, then you get x1 minus 2 squared plus 3 times x2 plus 1 squared equals 4. And let's just say the same as y1 squared plus 3y2 squared equals 4, which would be an ellipse. But now an ellipse centered around the point 2 minus 1 half. So here we have our, 2 minus 1. So here we have our point 2 minus 1, and we have our ellipse around it. So what happens if you have linear terms? You can always get rid of them if you complete the square. Only thing what happens is that the center of, in this case, your ellipse just shifts a bit. So that's all. Now, up till now, so what can we do more if we have a function of two variables? Well, up to now we have a positive term times x1 squared plus positive term times x2 squared equals, say, 1. If you would have two minuses, then you just put the constant to the right to a minus and get rid of it. But what happens if you have a plus and a minus? So what happens if you have, in this case, x1 squared over a squared minus x2 squared over b squared? Well, then something else is going to happen. Well, first of all, we're going to set this, for example, equal to 1. And what happens if you intersect the x1 axis? That means x2 equals 0, so your x1 equals plus a over here or minus a over there. What happens if you try to intersect the x2 axis and set it to 1? Then you get minus x2 squared over b squared equals 1. And that's impossible, because you have negative equals 1, so we will have no intersections with the x2 axis. Now we can look what happens for big values of x1 and x2. Well, if you have x1 squared over a squared minus x2 squared over b squared equals 1, and if your x1 and x2 are going to be very big, then you can neglect the 1 basically, so you get x1 squared over a squared equals x2 squared over b squared, or a line of form y equals b over a times x, which is sketched over here. So in the limit you will go towards this line over here for very large values of x1 and x2. So how do the curves, how do the level sets look like? Something like this over here, something like that over here, and symmetric. So our level sets in this case will become hyperbolas.